this is what March Madness is all about. You saw it firsthand. You saw a very well-coached, a very good Gardner-Webb team, regular season champions, make a championship run on us at the end of the game. I think we got a little comfortable with the lead and just didn't take care of the ball. But it, my hat goes off to a very well-coached team, a team that is a champion team. And we mentioned it at halftime. There is going to be a championship run out of them, and certainly saw it. And they took the lead on us. Very pleased with how we pulled ourselves back together and came up with some composed plays and attacked the basket, and especially how we defended when we had a two-point lead and they had the ball down there. They had been very successful in late game scenarios, beating us, beating Purdue, and I think our defensive effort there, switching, contesting their outside shot, gave them an opportunity to drive to the basket and execute that, but put us in a situation where we could win the game with the last second shot. So very pleased with the defensive effort that the team did at the end of the game.
Devin, I think you were joking a little bit last week when you said you had something on your sleeve. Clearly, just taking your team on your back,
I mean, we wanted to win the Big South, so I mean, we came ready. I mean, at the beginning, I mean, we came out, we really pumped up, and in the second half, we knew they was gonna go on a run. We just tried to defend it, and I mean, at the end of the day, we came out to we won the game. So
taking through the two shots and what you saw and what you were able to.
I mean, on the first one, I felt her on my back. So, I mean, she was behind. She was on my left side. I mean, my right side. So, I just went the other way, and then I turned in, and she was in between. So, I just put it underneath of her. And then the last one, I mean, we just ran. We just set the play. We was running it, and she stepped back. So, I pulled up, and I said in my head, just hit it high and so off the glass.
Then shut her eyes.
And closed them and prayed. And then it went in, and I went that way.
Amber, talk a little bit about what it meant to you to foul out, but then have your, kind of your bench, your depth, pick up the slack.
Oh, it kind of hurt that I fouled out, but I got a lot of confidence in my team. I knew they wouldn't let me down. They wasn't going to make this my last game and let me foul out. And I mean, I just knew my team was going to come through with me.
Do you have a lot of experience in high school with being on the shot?
No. Not at all. No. This is the first.
Rachel, during their run with 18 out there, how much did it look like you guys were really kind of just tightened up in there, especially with the ball game? What did you guys say during those timeouts to try to calm yourself down?
More just encourage each other, because we knew they were going to make a run. Just like Coach mentioned, that's what we talked about in halftime. We knew they were going to make a run, but we just had to stay together and fight together as a team. And to really just keep working together and just stay focused on what Coach Green had us running and what we were going to do as a team, and just stay focused on that instead of focusing on them.
Did their backcourt trap kind of bother you a little bit there?
I messed up, but I wouldn't say it bothered me per se, but I did turn them all over, so I guess it served its purpose for Gardner-Webb.
And Amber, what's going through your mind as that lead's just slowly ticking away and you guys are struggling on offense, not getting good shots?
I knew we was going to win the whole time. Like I said, I got a lot of confidence in my team. I knew God wasn't going to let me down this time. So I was like, just stay strong, just finish strong. When they started hitting their threes, I was like, dang, they may go on and run, they're going to get hot. But I knew we had to keep our composure and run our stuff. A lot of the calls didn't go our way, but in the end, we succeeded, so.
Devin, tournament MVP for someone who never made a game-winning shot in high school. How does that feel?
It feels good. Feels great. Feels great. It's all for my teammates. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't get anything.
Devin, what did you talk about in the timeout? Knowing if you had made the shot, what you thought Gardner-Webb was going to do coming back down because they didn't have any timeouts. And what was kind of the defensive strategy on make?
Oh, we was going to score and get back on defense because we knew they was going to push it. So we just knew if we scored, we had to get back. And so that was just our mentality. We just had to get back.
Were you trying to make sure they didn't try to get a three off?
Oh, yes. Yeah. So I was trying to run her down. Oh, I let her go. I said,
Coach, was that kind of the play that was drawn up that actually occurred with Devin scoring on that play? Is that, was it close to what you thought it would look like?
For the most part, you know, she was to get the ball, and post player was to give her the ball. They changed up defenses on us, and she did exactly where we wanted her to go with it, but Devin was the one that made the shot. Her determination and, you know, really some calmness there, and they executed. I don't know if we had any rebounders on the backside or whatever, but she made a big shot.
Is this game just destined to go out of the last shot? I mean, it seems like every year, you're up 20 or so there in the second half, and the game still comes down to a final shot.
I think, Dennis, that's what championship games usually turn out to be, very close. And it has been the history that the last several years it's been a 2-point, a 1-point. There's not been too many blowouts in the last 6 or 7 years. So we're very blessed. We're fortunate, and we're thankful.
Amber, I'll ask almost the same question to you. Almost the same situation as last year. What are your thoughts while you're sitting on the bench there?
I mean, I wasn't nervous. I was kind of excited. Because I knew Devin was going to score. Like just knowing her as a player all year, I just knew she was going to take her. I was going to foul her. So I knew we were going to win at that point. I just worried about making sure we got back on defense and didn't let them get the shot off.
Devin, Gardner-Webb has most everybody coming back. You guys have most everybody coming back. I mean, how do you see this? I mean, it's a competitive rivalry on the court and everything. Just kind of.
It's going to be a battle. Yeah. I mean, we both, I mean, we lose one, they lose a couple. So, I mean, it's going to be a battle. It's going to be fun, though.
Yeah!
Oh.
That's how we feel.
Yes, it is.
That's how we feel.
That's my man, Gary.
That was a quote by Mr. Gary Householder.
Yes.
Outside.
Any further questions for coach and student athletes?
Just one for the athletes. With, given how you guys were able to kind of spread it around so much with the minutes in the first couple of games to come down to this game, did that help a little bit just in terms of maybe having your legs under you a little more than they did?
Yeah, I think so. I think our bench played just as well as we play as a starting play.
Yeah.
So I think it's great to have a bench who can play at the same tempo as starting five, so when you get in, it's not much of a change.
And then you get in games like these, and everybody's fresh.